all is well. Whenever there is a problem, repeat over and over to yourself, all is well. Everything is working out for my highest good. Out of this situation, only good will come, and I am safe. Doing this will work miracles in your life. This is Louise Hay, and I love you. Joy and blessings to you all. It thrills my heart to present this book to you, dearest reader, whether you're new to my work or a longtime follower. All is Well looks at my teachings from a fresh and exciting angle. My co-author, Mona Lisa Schulz, who I love and adore, has been promising me for ages that she would pull together scientific evidence to support what I have been teaching for years. While I personally do not need proof to know that these methods work, I rely on what I call my inner ding to evaluate things. I do know there are many people who will only consider a new idea if there is science behind it. So here we present the science to you. With this added information, I know that a whole new segment of people will become aware of the power they have to heal their bodies.
Chapter 1. Integrating Healing Methods. Healing the mind and body with affirmations, medicine, and intuition is territory that has been increasingly explored over the last 30 years. And though there are many brilliant and gifted individuals who have helped lead the way, few would argue that the first pioneer in this field was Louise Hay. In fact, this movement began en masse in the 1980s when we all bought her little blue book, Heal Your Body, The Mental Causes for Physical Illness and the Metaphysical Way to Overcome Them. And we discovered the thought patterns that led to the health problems we all had. Who knew what a turn my life would take because of this little blue book? But it truly has changed everything. It helped me sculpt my own medical practice, and its theory has guided me along the path to better health for my patients and myself. As you can imagine, I was thrilled, actually beyond thrilled, when Hay House proposed that I write a book with Louise that brought together the healing power of intuition, affirmations, and medicine, both traditional Western medicine and alternative therapies. It's the ultimate healing system. To work with this material and with Louise, how could I say no? I had dragged Healing Your Body along with me to medical school, and later, as I spent long years researching the brain in pursuit of my PhD, I used it when I cried through the ups and downs of my medical and scientific training, and the times I didn't cry and came down with sinusitis and postnasal drip. I would look up in the book the associated thought pattern. Postnasal drip, also known as inner crying. When I got nervous about taking out one student loan after another, yes, to pay all that tuition, I started to get sciatica, lower back problems. Once again, I turned to Louise Hay's little blue book. Sciatica was associated with fear of money and of the future. Time after time, the book made sense. But I could never figure out where Louise got all that affirmation system. What motivated her nearly 35 years ago to start her clinical observation study on the association between human thoughts and health? How could someone with no scientific background or medical training observe client after client, see a consistent correlation between certain thought patterns and their associated health problems, and then write a book that so accurately addresses our health concerns. Her prescriptions worked, but I didn't know why or how. It simply drove me crazy. So as necessity, or aggravation, is the mother of invention, I decided to delve into the science behind her affirmation system, mapping out the emotional aspects of illness in the brain and in the body. And the correlations I found helped me create a treatment system that has guided me through more than 25 years of intuitive consultations and an equal number of years as a physician and a scientist. But it wasn't until Louise and I started down the path of writing this book that I realized how powerful combining the healing methods I use with Louise's affirmations could actually be. The importance of intuition. Back in 1991, I had finished 2 years of medical school training, plus 3 years of my PhD, and I needed to go back to the hospital floor to do my residency. Armed with a white coat, stethoscope, and a lot of little books, I entered the floors of what at the time was Boston City Hospital. On the first day, my resident came to me, gave me the name and the age of my first patient, and said simply, "Work her up." That was it. I was terrified. How was I supposed to go figure out what was wrong with her when I had no information other than her name and her age? In the elevator, on the way down to the emergency room, I fidgeted nervously. I just knew only the rudiments of how to work up a patient, let alone how to operate the stethoscope around my neck. Trapped in the elevator, I stood with my clipboard in my hand, and there, in an instant, I saw in my mind's eye an image of the patient I was about to evaluate. She was, moderately obese, in lime green stretch pants, clutching the right upper part of her abdomen, screaming, "Doctor, doctor, it's my gallbladder." "Wow," I thought. In the event that the patient I was about to meet does have a gallbladder problem, how would I evaluate the medical problem? As the elevator slowly crept in between floors, I flipped through the pages of the numerous manuals stuffed in my pockets, and I quickly researched how I was going to work up a patient with a gallbladder problem. On my clipboard, I sketched out, you know, the classic workup one does for a gallbladder problem. You check out the ultrasound of the liver, you check the liver enzymes, you observe the whites of the patient's eyes. Poof, the door opened, I ran down to the emergency room and threw open the curtain, and there, to my surprise, was a woman lying in the gurney saying, "Doctor, doctor, it's my gallbladder." Yes, she had the lime green stretch pants. She was exactly the way I saw her. It had to be a coincidence, right? The second day, once again, the resident barked out the name and the age of my patient, telling me to go down once again to the emergency room. And again, an image of the patient popped into my mind, this time with a bladder infection. So I ran the drill again. How would I treat a patient with a bladder infection? Lo and behold, it was a bladder infection. On the third day, I repeated the process again, and again, my intuitive impressions were accurate. After 3 days, I realized there was something unique about my brain, that my mind's eye could see ahead of time what my trained medical eye would eventually see on the floors of the hospital. I could see just how useful intuition was in helping me assess my patients, but I soon realized that intuition played an even larger role than I initially thought. The body's intuition. The human body is an amazing machine.
And as a machine, it requires regular maintenance and care to run as efficiently as possible. There are a variety of reasons your body can break down and get sick. Whether it's genetics, the environment, diet, and so on. But as Louise found in her career and published in Heal Your Body, every illness is affected by emotional factors in your life. And decades after Louise presented her conclusions, the scientific community has put forth studies that actually support them. Research has shown that fear, anger, sadness, love, joy, all of the emotions have specific effects on the body. We know that anger makes muscles clamp down and blood vessels constrict, leading to hypertension and resistance to blood flow. Cardiac medicine, heart medicine, tells us that joy and love tend to have the opposite effect. If you look at Louise's little blue book, a heart attack and other heart problems are squeezing all the joy out of the heart. A hardening of the heart. And
we hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.